House of Angel TV, and a special warm welcome to all the little children that have been watching Granny's Daily program week after week. May you be blessed with the experiments and the Word of God. You know, every time you see one experiment and you read the Word of God, something is happening in the inside, and that's very important. Now, God is always wanting to show us through the experiments something special from the Word of God. That we can walk in the power of His might, right? Yeah. So, the name of this episode is The Power of the Boat. Oh, there is a boat. Are we going to do a boat? Maybe. Get ready. There's some exciting experiment coming up, and you will be able to do it with some things that you can find at home. But first of all, we need to know, what does the Lord want to tell you and you and all the little children of the world? He wants to make sure that you grow and you flow in the amazing power of His Spirit. He wants to encourage all the children to hold tight to the Lord. And not to our power, but to His power. Not to our ways, but His ways. So His power is revealed in this world through you, His little children. Amen. Mm-hmm. Through you and through you, God wants to show His power. And He wants all the little children to believe that He has lots of power ready and available for all of you to do God's will. How? By His Holy Spirit. All right. So, we are going to do some experiments. So, we need to know what we need. What do we need?
The materials.
The materials. So, we need to find out what are the materials for this experiment. So, I'm on the material. We will need a pair of scissors. Make sure it's not a dangerous scissor, too sharp. Granny Stella is using it like that, but you make sure you have an adult with you. Also, I hope you have a pen and paper to take notes of what is going on and how we do this. And also make note of the scriptures so you can discuss them with your friends and you can discuss it with your family. Amen. So you need some skewers. This little thing with a sharp point that sometimes you can put meat and you can put vegetables or things like that, and then you barbecue. That's what you need, two of them. Then you need maybe a lid or something like that. Then you need a punch hole, a punch holder, and you need some, what is this?
Rubber band.
Rubber band, that's right. And then you need two of this. Was this?
A cup.
Made of, what was there inside? Do you know what was there inside?
Huh?
Margarine or butter. So you need two containers of butter or margarine. So, now that I think we have everything, it's time for
experiment!
That's right, time for experiment, to be excited with it. We're going to do. I already pre-prepared one of the butter containers. and I cover it up like that. And what you do is, so this one is ready made, but what you do is with glue, you need glue or you need, you can use also blue tack. Use blue tack or something to, or very strong tape, a sticky tape, to put on the side of your butter container, the stick that comes out a fair bit. You do that on both sides, just like this. And then you can actually paint it, or you can cover it up, and you can put windows, and you can do all sorts of things, make it look like a really lovely boat. Now, from the lid of the second butter tub or margarine tub, you cut a little piece that is not bigger than the body of this one. So on this side. So it's going to be a little bit smaller, right, than this. And make sure then that you punch a hole almost in the middle. Uh-oh. I did punch it in the wrong place. Then you cut straight to the hole. Make a cut to the hole. All right. We're going to ignore this third hole. It's not necessary. Then what we're going to do is we are going to put, and then what we are going to do is we are going to put the rest of the rubber band like this. Okay, you got it? Like that. All right. So once you've done that, meanwhile we are going to read the scriptures. But let me show you the little boat in here. Okay, what's happening to the boat?
It was floating.
It's floating. Apart from floating, anything else happening?
No.
No. It's not moving, right? Is it moving? Can you see it move at all?
No.
No. Can't see it move. So let's look at some scriptures. And see what the Lord is saying, and at the same time that we are doing this experiment. Have you got your Bibles together with you? So I'd like you to look at the book of James in the chapter 1 and verse 19.
Now this, my beloved brothers, let every person be quickly to hear, slow to speak, slow to anger. For the anger of the man does not produce the righteousness of God.
Okay, thank you so much. So, what is he saying, the Lord, that we should do? Be slow to what? Verse 19, let every man
slow to speak.
Slow to speak, quick to what?
Quick to hear.
Quick to hear, and slow to what?
Anger.
Slow to anger. So God is, what God is saying? Don't talk too much. Be more willing to listen. You're going to learn a lot more when you listen than when you talk a lot. And then he says, don't be too quick to get angry and offended. Be slow to get angry. Don't just get angry at anything. Have you experienced that? That some things happen, you get angry quickly? Have you experienced that? Or you get offended?
Yeah.
Yeah? What about you? Yeah, you get angry quickly sometimes? Yes. Yes, sometimes we get angry quickly. And that's why God is teaching the children, don't get angry quickly. He's saying, be slow to anger. And, you know, why do we get angry, really? Why do we get angry?
Someone would tell us to, we have bad things to us. They will tell to us means we get angry. And someone touch us things, so we get angry.
That's right. We get angry when people play around with our things, our possessions, right?
Yeah.
But we need to know that the things we have, they come from Jesus, right?
Yeah.
So we shouldn't be too possessive with what we've got, right? So I'd like us to think on that. I like us to consider not to get angry so easily. Amen?
Amen.
Not get cranky all the time. Because sometimes we get angry because things don't go our way. That means to say, who wants to be the boss? We want to be the boss. We want things to go the way we want, right?
Yeah.
But God is teaching us that not always we can have our way. Sometimes we need other people to let other people have their way. So that way we'll learn not to get angry because things are not the way we want them to be. Remember that. So in the next verse, verse 21, it says, I'll read it. Get rid of all uncleanness and rampant outgrowth of wickedness, and in a humble, gentle, modest spirit, receive and welcome God's word, which implanted and rooted in your heart will contain the power to save your soul. So we must let go of all those things, right? Anger, malice, all that rage, all that has to go. And so we put the Word of God inside of us, because in the Word of God, there is power to save us from the hands of the enemy. Amen. When we do the wrong things, who comes?
The devil.
The devil comes. We invite the devil by doing wrong things. But when we choose not to do wrong things, we choose to fill our hearts with the Word of God, then God
will
give us power and fills us up. So the devil cannot come near us. That's right.
Yeah.
That's how it is. So we're going to say, well, this person, obviously, this boat is a person. And this person has been listening to all the word we said. Has he done anything about it? What do you think?
No.
It doesn't look. But you know what? The Bible tells us in verse 22, be doers of the word. So you can wind this up. Why this experiment, but you turning it around and around and around and around, is you making an effort to obey the word of God, doing something about it. You heard the word of God, you understood the word of God, so now you're doing something about it. You are acting the word of God, right? So not just a listener, but a doer. Because if you are just a listener of the word, you will deceive yourself. So you will believe lies. The lies of the devil will deceive you. Your heart will be deceiving you. Okay, by the reasonings of the enemy. So you think that I did enough of this?
Yeah.
Okay, so when we decide to obey God's word and become doers of God's word, it's like this little rudder of the boat is being wound up with the power of the Holy Ghost, the power to save us. And let's see what happens here.
It gets moves.
A little boat will move in all by himself. And what is that? That is the power that the word can put inside of us. So how do you like this? How do you like this experiment?
Allah.
Interesting. So you can do this experiment to prove that the word of God can move us. And when we make it, when we try to obey the word of God, when we work obeying the word of God, the Spirit of God will move us forward with the power to save us from all the lies of the enemy. But if we don't do nothing like this, guess what's happened? The enemy can come, right? And he can pull us down and sink the boat. You don't want the hand of the enemy to do that. So if he has done that, God will pick us up with his hand as we repent and say, sorry, Lord, I want to follow your word. And then the moment we start doing, oh, this is another one that cut. We will be on the move for heavenly ways again. God wants all the little children to be moved by what?
Moved by God.
By God! And whose spirit?
Holy Spirit.
That's right. Not ungodly spirit, not the spirit of this world, but the spirit of God. Amen. So let's look at the verse 23. If anyone only listens to the words without obeying it and being a doer of it, he is like a man who looks carefully on the mirror. He pays attention on the mirror, right? But what happens in verse 24? He observes himself, but then he goes out and forgets the way he looks. You know, the word of God is like a mirror. And we look into the word of God, and the word of God shows us by the power of the light of God and through the Holy Spirit what's inside our hearts and convicts us. You know, you've been lying, or you've been lazy, you haven't been reading the word of God, or you have been saying wrong things, or you have been watching wrong movies, playing wrong games. When the word of God begins to convict our hearts, God is showing us what's inside. We can say, Lord, yeah, this is what's happened. Lord, forgive me, Lord. But we haven't really paid attention to the word of God. It really didn't really go all the way to the heart. That's why we need to read it again and again. If it touches our heart, we need to read it again and again until we remember. And when we are presented with a time that choose from lying to not lying, then the word of God will pop up and will say, don't lie, right? So God is so wonderful. He's teaching us to do what is right. And it is through the word that we learn to walk in his righteousness. Amen. In verse 25, he says, but he who looks carefully and faithfully in the word of God, which is the book of instruction on how we ought to live in this earth, we will find liberty. So all perverseness will be removed. You know, God wants the best for us. And he wants us to show the best of him upon this earth. So, when you look in the mirror of the word of God, some things God is talking to us that we should not do, something that he's teaching us that we should do, we should pay good attention and not forget about it and go and do the same thing. So how can we do that? Sometimes we can't help it, right? We keep on doing the same silly thing, right? Has it happened to you? Had it happened to you? Happened to me sometimes. But with prayer, God hears all of our prayer. And we can ask God to help us not only to listen to the word of God, but to practice it. Amen.
Amen.
Let's ask God to help us to do His will. Amen. So let's hold our little hands. Meanwhile at home, if you have been saying wrong things, if you have been allowing anger into your life, and if you don't have your way, you get angry with mom and with dad and your friends and everybody else, it's time to say sorry to God and ask Him to help you not to be angry. Is that right? Shall we do that? And God will help us. And we'll ask God that we'll be doers of the Word of God, right? Would you like to pray?
Yeah. Lord, help us to be your help. Take us to move and give us your words in our hearts. Not let the devil come in our hearts. Please let us do your words and forgive us that we do in the ways, and let me do your way, and let your words come into our hearts. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen. And Lord, listen to all the little children, for you are a good God and a merciful God. And Lord, you love the little ones, and you love everyone and all your creation, because you are love and you are merciful and gracious and slow to anger. Listen to them. Some of them are confessing, Lord, that they have allowed anger all the time. They did not know that they were doing wrong against you, and that they were opening doors to the devil. So today, as they repent, as we all repent, Lord, we close the doors to the devil. We cut every communication, everything we had in common with the devil, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, fill our little hearts. Fill the gaps in our hearts with your Holy Spirit, with your love and your fire, and heal every hurt that was made by the enemy through these things that we didn't know they were wrong, Lord. And in the name of Jesus, we pray this. Amen. We give you all the glory, Lord, in Jesus' name. Dear beloved, it's been so good to be together. I hope you enjoy the experiment, and I hope you can make some boats and have wonderful time playing with your friends and doing boats like this and speaking the Word of God through this experiment to all your friends and even to the Sunday school kids or at school. My beloved, God loves you so much. We need to go right now because we're to the end of this episode. But we are coming back again with more experiments and more wonderful revelations of God's Word and God's love for us. So, until we meet again, God bless you!